El hombre que escuchan es John Fogerty. Nos atiende a esta hora. John, hello, good morning.
Hello, how are you?
Mariana, yo quisiera saber... Fine, thank you. Mariana, quisiera saber cuál es la conexión de Juan Gabriel con esta canción. ¿Por qué llega Juan Gabriel a esta canción?
Mr. Fogerty, we'd like to know, what is the connection between Juan Gabriel and this song and you?
Well, I first became aware of Juan's recording when it was on YouTube, maybe 2.5 months ago, something like that. That was the first, actually, that I knew about this recording. And so I watched it on YouTube, and I just really loved it. And I said, you know, I have to tell him that I love his recording so much. And so that sort of started me trying to get in touch with Juan.
La canción la vio en YouTube por primera vez hace como 2 meses y medio y le encantó tanto que de ahí nació la idea que tenía que conectarse con Juan Gabriel y de ahí nació la conexión.
Oh, pero me sorprende esta respuesta porque uno creería que un álbum completo como el que hicieron varios artistas latinos, Quiero Credence, que es el disco donde está esta canción, pues habría contado con alguna aprobación de ellos. Entonces, ¿no se enteraron de que salió un disco completo en homenaje a Creedence Clearwater Revival en castellano con artistas latinos?
We're a little bit surprised by your response because there's an entire album basically in Spanish that is devoted to Creedence and your band. So we'd like to know, did you not know that?
I'm not quite sure I understood the question. You mean, did I not know that he had recorded?
There was an entire album with a lot of songs in your band's honor.
You are correct. I did not find out about it until it was just about to be released. Unfortunately, that is the way, you know, the music business is sometimes. The record company really didn't involve me. You will notice that my name is actually mentioned once. All songs written by John Fogerty. But I decided to not let that bother me because all of the artists who recorded these songs were so sincere. And, you know, I love the idea that they are recording my songs, and especially Juan's version of Have You Ever Seen the Rain. I just think it's beautiful. And so I very much wanted to be in contact with Juan Gabriel. Of course, I knew that my music was very popular in the Latin music world. But I, you know, I don't speak Spanish, so I don't always understand what is being sung or what is being said. But I knew this time it was very important that I get to talk to Juan.
Efectivamente, él no sabía sobre este disco, Juan Pablo. Y pues, digamos que eso es culpa un poco de la disquera, porque nunca se le comunicó y así funciona, digamos, el mundo, la industria de la música. Pero bueno, él dice que no le molestó porque se siente honrado, absolutamente honrado de que bueno, en este disco hay grandes figuras y fantásticos artistas. Y eso para él es un honor, en especial la canción de Juan Gabriel.
Escuchemos otro clásico de esta inolvidable banda.
People grow, I suppose, from the way they were as children. You know, when success comes, there are a lot of different personalities and a lot of different pictures in people's minds, I guess you might say. I know that there was a lot of jealousy and that sort of thing, a lot of envy. And it finally becomes so much that everything explodes. It's kind of like a divorce.
A lo último que dijo es clave, como un divorcio, porque al principio pues empiezan con muchos sueños, con una, digamos, una pintura de lo que ellos quieren que sea el futuro, pero pues eso cambia y vienen los celos, vienen la envidia y al final eso es como un divorcio, puede romper las cosas.
Mariana, aprovechando a John, muchas personas catalogan a Neil Young y a Creedence Clearwater como los abuelos del grunge. Yo quisiera saber si él cree que eso es así.
Mr. Fogerty, many people characterize you or label you as the parents or of grunge. Would you say that is true? Do you identify yourself as such?
Well, probably because I wore flannel shirts a lot, and when grunge came along, many of the bands were wearing flannel shirts. You know, it was something I really didn't think about until other people pointed it out, but if there's a connection, I'm very proud of that.
Probablemente esa conexión se da a que él se ponía unas camisetas de franela, y en esa época pues también otras bandas lo hacían. Digamos que no era la intención, no se sabía que se les iba a catalogar como los padres del grunge, pero si esa es la conexión, se siente honrado y orgulloso.
A mí me gustaría preguntarle al señor Fogerty si sigue pensando que la Creedence Clearwater Revival es la mejor banda de rock de la historia, solo por detrás de los Beatles.
Do you still believe that Clearance Clearwater is the best rock band only after the Beatles?
Well, many people have said that. I know I tried very hard, and all the fellas tried very hard back in the day, back in the late 60s, to be the best that we could. You know, I have always thought the Beatles, of course, were the top, the best. Mm-hmm. And I know that I used to tell the guys in the band, well, the Beatles will always be number one, so we can try to be number two. That's okay. It's not too bad if we're number two.
Bueno, hay un toque de humildad no solamente en su voz, sino en su respuesta, porque él nos dice que primero es lo que la gente dice de ellos, pero que, bueno, mientras que ellos trabajaban muy duro y se esmeraban para ser excelentes, él siempre les decía a su banda, los Beatles siempre van a ser los primeros, eso sí, ahí no hay discusión, pero bueno, por lo menos nosotros podemos intentar de ser los segundos.
Y para muchos lo fueron, por canciones como esta.
Esta canción, Mariana, es impresionante porque la bailó mi papá en los años 60, 60 y no, 70, pero todavía hoy en mi generación, en el año 2000, se sigue escuchando y sigue sonando y sigue siendo muy famosa. Yo quisiera preguntarle a él, ¿a qué se debe el éxito de la banda de tantos años?
Mr. Fogerty, my colleague here, Yvonne, says that her dad danced to this song in the 70s a lot, but today people still dance it just as much as it was danced to at that time. Why do you believe this song and others that you composed with Creedence Clearwater, why do you believe you have had so much success?
Well, I think the songs were very pure. There was no extra frills, you might say, or decoration. They were very pure and direct and simple, so that I think the melody and the rhythm and, of course, the words that I created were taken to heart, you know, and understood by people. At least that's the way I felt. When I finished Proud Mary, which was my very first good song in my whole life, I really knew that it was a good song. I mean, I looked at it on the piece of paper. Seconds after I had finished it, and I just felt that it was, that it resonated. It certainly resonated with me, and if it was something that I liked, I was hoping that other people would like it too.
Bueno, estas canciones, Yvonne, son canciones muy puras, digamos, con las letras son muy simples, el ritmo también es muy sencillo. Entonces, digamos que eso le facilita comunicarse con un público y pues con la gente que tanto les gustó estas canciones. Ahora, él dice que él reconoce una buena canción que ha compuesto segundos o minutos después de que terminó de componerla, y que él sabe que eso es una buena canción. Por ejemplo, la primera, él dice que era Proud Mary, la primera que él dice que es su primera buena canción, y que él la reconoció inmediatamente, y así lo fue, tuvo una fantástica recepción.
La música de los años 60 estuvo marcada por un festival, Woodstock. Tengo entendido que ellos tocaron en ese festival, pero yo no los he visto nunca en el vídeo oficial, ni he tenido conocimiento de ninguna imagen pública de Fogerty y sus chicos tocando en Woodstock. ¿Por qué?
Why I exactly? I mean, we have an image of you playing in Woodstock. Why, like, why does that image remain so iconic as well? Why does it live in our memories?
It's very interesting. I don't know if you know the story, but I actually declined to have the song they had chosen for my band, for Creedence, to be in the movie of Woodstock back in the early 70s, because I felt that it was very late and the audience was asleep. And so I felt that we weren't getting a great reaction. But yet Creedence was doing very well every place else that we performed. And so it wasn't until, I think, in the 90s, I finally said, okay, they were doing a re-release of Woodstock, the movie. And so I said, well, okay, you know, it's fine now. Because originally, by the time the movie Woodstock came out, Creedence had already broken up. So it really wasn't affecting us either way, as far as I could see. But I suppose a memory like that from on such an iconic night is, it even gets bigger and more magical down through the years. I suppose that's why it's so remembered.
La historia detrás de la canción que vimos en la película es muy interesante, porque cuando ellos en verdad la tocaron en el evento, parece que no hubo una reacción así muy emocional o muy energética. En verdad la gente estaba como un poquito más dormida, entonces ellos como banda se opusieron a que se tocara la canción o se utilizara la canción en la película. Sin embargo, después cuando volvieron a lanzar la película en los 90s, bueno, ya no les molestó y pensaban que era una gran canción, entonces el proyecto siguió adelante y pues bueno, igual se volvió gracias a eso una canción muy icónica.
Señor Fogerty, usted ha tocado canciones con mensajes de protesta. Incluso hay muchísimas personas que han utilizado sus canciones para protestar por una causa común. Si fuera a tomar una de esas canciones para describir la situación actual que se vive en los Estados Unidos, ¿cuál sería?
Mr. Fogerty, a lot of your songs have, you know, been composed with a spirit of, say, protest of some issue that is bothering or bothering the world at the moment. If there was one such song that you could pick that would represent a protest for any situation that the United States might be going through, which one would it be and why?
Well, I think I would choose Fortunate Son because, of course, it was written during the Vietnam War and was a reaction to the American government's policy during that war. But I also was talking about the inequality between classes, between, of course, the rich and the not rich, because it is very unequal. And that because I was in the Army myself, and so I had seen sort of from the inside of the military, and I was a young man in his country, just feeling that poor people and people with no voice were being taken advantage of. And so I talked specifically about that in the song Fortunate Son. It's a very angry song. And the amazing or the ironic and sad thing is that that song still has a lot of meaning even nowadays.
La canción sería Fortunate Son, la escribió con mucha rabia, no solamente en protesta a lo que estaba ocurriendo en Vietnam, porque él en sí fue un soldado también, entonces digamos que esa situación le molestaba mucho, pero también porque habían muchas diferencias entre clases sociales, había pobreza, y que lastimosamente esa situación se sigue viviendo hoy en día, y bueno, por eso él protesta también con esta canción.
El señor Fogerty está ahora como solista, bueno, desde el 72, ha seguido cantando solo. Va a tener una semana espectacular a partir del 14 de septiembre en el espectacular Hotel Venecia, el Venetian Hotel en Las Vegas. Estará exactamente dos semanas en ese fastuoso hotel con sus canciones como solista y los recuerdos de Creedence Clearwater Revival. Otra canción que tenía que ver con la lluvia de 1970. ¿Quién puede parar la lluvia?
Mariana, preguntémosle al señor Fogerty si él o sus compañeros de la banda nunca pensaron que de pronto ese nombre, Creedence Clearwater Revival, era muy largo, era muy enredado, era poco comercial para una banda que se proyectaba en tiempos en que empezaban a existir nombres muy efectivos para las bandas musicales.
Mr. Fogerty, when you and your band members thought about the name that you were going to give to your band, did you ever think that the name Creedence Clearwater Revival was going to be too long, maybe, especially at a time where bands were already beginning to use shorter names?
No, I felt very proud of that name when I came up with it. I thought it was unusual and perfect for the time. I've never second guessed that part. I still think it's a great name.
Nunca les generó alguna duda el nombre. Él se siente muy orgulloso de ese nombre que le dieron a la banda y que hasta hoy en día se siente muy satisfecho con esa elección.
Él y su banda en 1972 se desintegraron, pero tengo entendido que el dueño del sello que les publicaba se quedó con los derechos de sus canciones. Cuénteme bien esa historia y dónde han acabado esos derechos. ¿Los tienen ustedes? ¿Se los quedó definitivamente el dueño del sello?
We understand that even though your band disintegrated, the label that was managing you has kept the right to your songs. We'd like to ask you about that situation today, if maybe you can expand. Do they still have the rights to your songs, or were you able to get them back?
No, the label still owns all the songs that I wrote during that time. This has to do with copyright laws in the United States, but I have been very patient. It will take 56 years before, from the beginning, before I will get my songs back. So in about 9 or 10 years, I will start to become the owner of my own songs. And so on that day, I'm going to be a very happy man.
Por cuestiones de leyes en Estados Unidos, el sello es el dueño de los derechos de sus canciones, las canciones que ellos produjeron y compusieron durante pues la vida de la banda como una. Sin embargo, faltan 10 años para que él pueda recuperar esos derechos.
Changing the weather, people walk around in fear.
Rafa, esta es la música de él como solista.
Sí, porque él como solista estuvo en España. Hizo un concierto que se llamaba Músicos en la Naturaleza. Estuvo con Rosendo. Y él también tocó, cantó alguna canción con Miguel Ríos. Me gustaría que le preguntara, Mariana, al señor Fogerty, ¿cómo le fue por ese viaje por España? Y si le vamos a ver de nuevo por aquí.
You went to Spain for a while as a soloist, and you were singing your songs after the band broke up. We'd like to know, do you ever plan to go back to Spain, and are we going to see you again over there?
You mean as a band?
No, by yourself.
Oh, of course. Yes, I'm not sure if I understood the entire question, but I'm very happy to be performing in front of the people, and looking forward to all the shows I'm still going to do.
Sí, le encantaría volver a España como músico, hacer sus shows y bueno, a entretener a la gente de España con su música.
Esta canción se llama Change the Weather o Change in the Weather. Escuchamos dos canciones que tienen Rain. El nombre tiene Clear Water. En fin, ¿tienen como una obsesión con el agua y la naturaleza?
We're talking about your songs, this weather. This song is called Change in the Weather. Then you have another song that mentions rain. Then your band name has water in its name. Do you have a special relationship or maybe an obsession with water?
Well, I think with the elements of the earth, I feel very close to that. I think everyone does, really, if you stop and think about it. We are natural animals on this earth, and you know, those things are very close to me. All, you know, this song you are playing right now, Change in the Weather, that song scares me. I haven't thought about that song in a little while, and that's a very scary song to me.
No es solamente con el agua, es con todos los elementos de la tierra, y él cree que en verdad todos los seres humanos estamos conectados con esos elementos. Pero dice una cosa muy curiosa de acá, y es que en verdad esta canción le asusta.
En esta canción de 1970, uno de sus éxitos más famosos, Have You Ever Seen the Rain? John, thank you very much for your time. Thank you, honoring Juan Gabriel. And don't forget that you have a lot of fans here in Colombia.
Well, thank you so much. It's my great honor that Juan performed my song. And, you know, to have that happen in your lifetime is quite a wonderful thing. It's an honor to me. And thank you for having me here today. It was great to talk to you guys.
Where are you right now, John?
I am in Los Angeles.
Okay, good luck in Vegas, in the Venetian Hotel, huh?
Well, thank you so much. Come on over and see me, please.
I will, but you also come to Colombia and sing for us, please.
Oh, I would love to do that. Okay.
You're very kind, John. Good luck.
All right, thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.